It's another day again today, and welcome all of you to today's session. I'm very grateful to present to you again on economic topics. In our previous discussions or sessions, we look at what the theories that affect or the theories that determine what the exchange rate. We discussed the monetary approach, and we also discussed and we about to discuss the elasticity approach. I will be very grateful if you stay tuned and watch. For those of you that are writing examinations, I wish you good luck, and I hope that this video will be able to help you. If you do not understand something, please put it at the comment section. I would always be very glad and helpful to to answer your questions. And I will also appreciate if you can share this, like the video, and possibly give it a thumbs up. Let those who are schooling now or who are doing economics and struggling, do not understand the concept, maybe watching this video could help them. Thank you for sharing, and thank you for liking this video. In our previous session, we discussed the theories that, you know, determine the exchange rate. We discussed the monetary approach, and then the second one is the elasticity approach. Today, I would like us to focus on the elasticity approach. Now, what is the elasticity approach? The elasticity approach is a microeconomic explanation whereby foreign exchange rates are determined by demand and supply. In simple terms, it only means that it is an approach whereby demand and supply is used to determine the exchange rate. Now, if foreign exchange flows into domestic markets to pay for domestic exports and as capital inflows, when our currency or when a country's currency depreciates, or that is the value decreases, export becomes cheaper and people outside the country will buy more. The supply of foreign exchange will then increase. I'll take it again. If it happens that a country's currency depreciates or lost value, export becomes cheaper for people outside to buy, for foreign buyers, and that and thus the supply of foreign exchange will then increase. If the currency, the domestic currency, appreciates against the foreign currency, imports then become what? Cheaper. The demand for foreign exchange will increase as people and businesses would buy more imports. In simple terms, whenever the local currency or the domestic currency increases in value, what it means, it increases in value against the foreign currency, it becomes cheaper to import goods. And that affects the demand affects the increase in the demand for foreign exchange. Now, I want us to look at some definitions before we continue. Now, today's definitions, we're going to look at the CPI. The CPI, which stands for Consumer Price Index. Now, what is a CPI? A CPI is what? It's the official measure of what? Inflation. What is inflation? We all know that inflation is the what? Inflation is the general increase in the prices of goods and services. Now, consumer price index is a measure of prices of goods that influence the cost of living, such as transportation, food, and medical care. I've already explained what is inflation, but if you did not get it, inflation simply is a sustained increase of the general prices of goods and services in a country over a certain period of time. Just like I said, inflation is the general increase in the prices of goods and services over a period of time. We all know by now that prices keeps on changing with time. And the prices, the changes in those prices is what we refer to as inflation. Rate is a percentage increase in the prices of goods as calculated monthly. The increase in the prices of goods as, sorry, the percentage increase in prices of goods as calculated monthly. So if it is 5% increase, that is the rate. If it is 4% increase or 2% increase, that is the rate for that particular month. Now, what is depreciation? Whenever we talk of depreciation, we all should also discuss appreciation. Depreciation is the decrease in the general in the value of what? A currency or a country's currency. When the value of a country's currency drops, we call it depreciation. If depreciation happens, it means that that particular amount cannot buy what it used to buy. That is depreciation. Now, if you have $100 and depreciation occurs, let's say you have $100 that you can use to buy maybe, a ship, which costs $100. With time, if the dollar depreciates, you would have to look for more than $100 to buy that particular ship or ram. All right. So that is depreciation. Now, what is appreciation? Appreciation is the opposite of depreciation. What does not depreciate will definitely appreciate. Appreciation is the increase in the value of a currency. That is, if the currency has become stronger against the foreign currency. If a country's currency has become stronger against a foreign currency. Let's take for instance, if the South African rand is 17 rand as of today, and then against the US dollar, one US dollar. Now, whenever that reduces to $16 or $15 against the US dollar, we would say that the South African rand has what? Appreciated. We will say it has appreciated. So that is what appreciation and depreciation means. Now, I would also like us to look at devaluation. Devaluation is to fix the exchange rate at a lower level. That is what a lot of people do, is they take out one or two zeros to make that is to fix the exchange rate at a lower level. It's where the price of the currency is officially decreased in a fixed exchange rate system. Yes. Where they take out some few zeros just to make sure that that currency becomes relevant to the current situation. Now, if you have, let's say, a thousand rand, if you take out one or two zeros, it becomes 100. You see. Now, I would explain this further in my next video. Revaluation is to fix the exchange rate at a higher level. The value of the currency is officially increased within a fixed exchange rate system. I would explain these terms further. Terms of trade is the ratio between prices of export and the prices of imports. I will take it again. Terms of trade is the ratio between the prices of imports and the prices of export. If we are talking about terms of trade, I'm going to take it again. It's a ratio between the prices of export and the prices of import. Terms of trade is equal to average export price index over average import price index. You multiply that by 100. Multiply that by 100. With these explanations for this section, I would like to end this one here, and I thank everyone for watching. For those who have been supporting me this far, I thank you and I congratulate you for your participation. Please, if it happens that you did not understand something, you are freely advised to put your comment at the comment sections, and I will respond to it within the shortest possible time. I once again appreciate you for watching my videos and making contributions to it. I hope that it will be very helpful to you, if not to you, to a friend who is currently doing or reading economics. I thank you for watching. Thanks and bye.